Hello, everyone, and welcome to Mountain Lake Journal. I'm Tom Howick. This week, work is getting underway on the Champlain Hudson Power Express Project here on Lake Champlain. The New York Governor Kathy Hochul and dignitaries from the state and Quebec officially kicked off about a year and a half ago.
The project will deliver $6 billion worth of hydropower from Quebec the entire length of Lake Champlain and the Hudson River, more than 300 miles to New York City. It's a project that started with public hearings nearly 15 years ago, like this one held at the Chamber of Commerce in Plattsburgh during the summer of 2010. The project took several years to get all the necessary state and federal permits. Then, earlier this summer, all the equipment needed to lay the transmission line along the entire length of the lake was transported on barges up the Champlain Canal and Lake Champlain to the northern tip of the lake, where in the past couple of weeks, work has gotten underway. TDI, the company installing the cable, is working around the clock now to bury the transmission line that'll carry all that renewable energy, more than 1,250 megawatts, to New York City.
We're going to provide up to 20% of New York City's power through this cable. In water depths less than 150 feet, we'll be burying the cable to 4 feet below the lake bed. And then in water depths that are greater than 150 feet will be surface land.
The senior project manager says the work laying the transmission line started at the northern tip of the lake near Rouses Point. It is being done in 12-mile sections, 24 hours a day.
Once we come to the end of the 12.5-mile section, we stop. We take out the barges that are empty, we bring in new barges, and we splice those cable ends together, and then we continue the laying process.
As they inch closer to Plattsburgh, he says they will avoid disruptions with the lake's ferry traffic, as well as follow a pre-charted course that keeps the barges away from the historic shipwrecks resting at the bottom of the lake.
We have not heard from a lot of partners across the watershed in New York, Vermont, or Quebec significant concerns about habitat impacts or species impacts from implementing the line in the lake.
Meg Modley with the Patrick Leahy Lake Champlain Basin Program says the project is allocating more than $100 million in remediation funds for environmental groups, which will be released over the next 35 years. On Lake Champlain, the money will go to help conserve fish habitat and combat invasive species, like this fish, the round goby, which is slowly working its way closer to the lake.
Those projects are split between the Hudson and the Champlain drainage. And the projects that we're looking at specifically in Lake Champlain are related to fish population surveys and habitat conservation and aquatic invasive species spread prevention. So we're looking at how can we mitigate the spread of invasive species through the Champlain Canal to our south, through the Chambly Canal to our north. And if there are additional research needs like economic impact studies of invasive species in the lake that could be achieved with these funding dollars.
The work laying the transmission line along the bottom of Lake Champlain is expected to last through the end of the year, with the project scheduled to be up and running and providing power to New York City by May of 2026.